Service with you. On behalf of Nancy and her entire family, we want to thank you for your love, your comforting words of support, your prayers, and coming here today to share a life that was well lived.
Amen.
Nancy has been a blessing to others her whole entire life, and today we're here to bless her with the thoughts and memories and stories from her loved ones. Today's scripture verse comes from the book of John, the 11th chapter, beginning with the 25th verse. Now, this is a passage of scripture where Jesus comforts Mary and Lazarus after the death of their brother Lazarus. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who lives and believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she told him. "I believe you are the Christ, the Son of God, who was to come into the world." And so did Nancy. Let's have a word of prayer. Father God in heaven, we thank you for the love, your grace and mercy that you have given to us. We thank you that we can gather here today to share and honor Nancy's life. We thank you for her spirit and how she touched our lives. We thank you for the freedom which you have provided for us. Lord, as we continue our service, we ask that the Holy Spirit brings us peace and comfort. We ask you get us through the difficult times and days and weeks and months ahead. We ask as the holidays come and go that you keep us filled with fond memories of our life and our love. Be with us now, Lord, and fill us. We ask all these things in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Nancy E. Woods, 78, of Chester, passed away Saturday, September 24th, 2021, at the Weirton Geriatric Center. Born on December 22nd, 1942, in East Liverpool, Ohio, she was a daughter of the late Layman and Grace Birch Rice. Nancy was a graduate of Wells High School class of 1960. She dedicated many of her years working as the assistant city clerk here in Chester. Nancy was a member of the First Christian Church in Chester. She taught and loved those who who she cared about her faith, her family, humility, serving others, laughter, and enjoying life. She was wise, brave, humble, meek, and forever will be cherished by her family. Nancy will be deeply missed by her husband, Gerald Jackson Woods, daughters, Wendy and her husband, Rick, and Cindy and her husband, Jeff, her brothers, Lehman Rice Jr. of Chester, Terry Rice and his wife, Janet of Chester, grandchildren, Jessica, Emily, Lauren, and Cole, and a special friend that was like a daughter to her, Tam Sidenson. Being from a small town, we all know each other pretty well. And I guess I've known Jack and Nancy for somewhere between 35 and 40 years. I consider them dear friends. Over the years, I've visited with them in their living room, caught a few Steeler games with them, chased some cats off my lap, and we enjoyed our families, enjoyed sharing stories of the varied activities of the kids. Back in those days, I'd hear stories about Wendy and Cindy and their families, and over the years, I've heard more stories about their grandkids and their activities. This past Sunday, I had the opportunity to meet those grandkids. After hearing about them all these years, it's nice to meet you. Now, I heard Jack and Nancy would bring the grandkids treats, but they wouldn't bring Wendy and Cindy treats. And they're like, what's going on? Well, being a pap, I can completely understand. You love your kids, but the grandkids are cool. Let's see those things. They're pretty cool. I've heard trips about running up to the lake and even run up to Lake Erie for a hot dog. That's just what you did. Those are the moments, those are the times that make life special. A hot dog from a hot dog stand on Lake Erie. What a blessing. At this time, it's my pleasure to have Jessica come up and share some additional stories for us.
As you all know, Grandma Woods is a really special lady. And when I close my eyes and picture her, and I'm sure for many of you as well, I will always picture her sitting in her favorite chair. There's a true crime TV show on in the background, and her police scanner too.
Yes.
She's got her coffee, the nice lipstick stain on the rim. She's doing the crossword puzzles with a half-finished crochet project on one side of her, and probably a cat or two squished on her lap. And so that's why I'm gonna keep picturing her. She was a really talented person. Most of you probably have blankets or things like that that she crocheted for you over the years. She had a real talent. She was also an amazing cook and an even more amazing baker. And I'm sure that we all had plenty of enjoyment out of that particular skill. She was really generous with her time and those talents, and I know she did share those with us frequently, and so I know we're all very appreciative of that. As the oldest grandchild, I was very blessed to spend 31 years with her, and given that I also spent most of my weekends at Grandma and Opie's growing up, I got to spend an extra special lot of time with Grandma. So much of who I am is definitely a direct result of who she was, and I'm just so grateful. She helped teach me how to read, and this is something that we always connected on throughout life. She passed on her love of Stephen King and crime novels. She showed me the very best way to prepare coffee, which is, of course, with cream and no sugar, obviously. She helped get me out of my comfort zone to try new foods. We also tried to learn piano together around the same time, and I think we would both admit that didn't go very well for us, fortunately. We both loved listening to music, and so that was something that stuck with us too. We all, the kids and the grandkids, inherited her inability to keep plants alive. But also her love of animals and her empathy. You know, if there's ever been a crazier cat lady than me, it was her. So certainly I give her a lot of credit for that. But she also taught me a lot about the importance of being still, of enjoying nice weather on the porch, and appreciating the simple things. She was the least judgmental person I've ever met, and she had a way of making the people around her feel really comfortable. I genuinely felt like I could tell her anything, and she would listen with an open mind. She had a wicked sense of humor and an unexpected adventurous side that never ceased to surprise me, a lot like Grandma Grace. Her favorite place to buy birthday cards was Spencer Gifts. The funnier the better. I'm sure many of you were gifted those over the years too. She read 50 Shades of Grey before I did. She once told me that she really regretted not getting a tattoo before she got too old. So she was just a lot of fun. She was a fun person to be around. She loved to laugh. As most of you know, she spent the last couple years battling dementia, and you know, we all kind of saw little pieces of her get stripped away over the years, and the last thing that was still there was her sense of humor. We went out for lunch for her last birthday, and she didn't remember who I was, but we still joked, and we laughed, and we had a great time like we were still friends. And so, just so grateful that she has found the peace that she deserves, and that we all could spend time with her, and I'm just grateful to have her as my grandma.
And mercy you did was share with your family and loved ones. That was pretty cool. couple of days ago, I believe this is maybe Saturday, Wendy called me and shared the news about her mom, and she asked me if I would share in today's service, and I said, well, absolutely, an honor. And but I knew immediately what Bible verses I would share for Nancy. You see, Jack knew he had a good wife, and Cindy and Wendy knew that they were blessed with a good mom. So these scriptures that I'm sharing with you today, I think it really exemplify the life and the love that she gave to others. I'm going to be reading from the book of Proverbs, the first chapter and the 31st chapter. A wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her and lacks nothing of value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She opens her arms to the poor and extends her hand to the needy. Her husband is respected at the city gates, where he takes a seat among the elders of the land. She is clothed with strength and dignity. She can laugh at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom, and faithful instructions is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children arise and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her for it. Charm is deceptive, and beauty is fleeting. But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her the reward that she has earned, and let her work bring her praise in the city gates. For attaining wisdom and discipline, for understanding words of insights, for inquiring and discipline and prudent life, do what is right, just, and fair. For giving prudence to the simple, knowledge and discretion to the young, let the wise listen and add to their learning, and let the discerning be their guide. My dear friend Jack, you have been blessed, and we shared many times how well we married. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. To Wendy and Cindy, you have been shown by example by your mom how to live, love, and to give to others. I'm not surprised to see or hear how you were able to share with your mom and dad over the last few difficult years. The torch has been passed from one generation to the next. As your kids become parents, you'll get the joy and fulfillment of becoming grandparents. The Bible tells us in 2 Timothy chapter 4, starting in verse 6, for I'm already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time for my departure has come. As we prepare to end the service for Nancy, I must ask you, are you ready for your day of judgment? Are you ready to meet the Lord? You see, Nancy was. Our opening scripture today was, she believed that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, who was to come to the world and save us from our sins. Nancy believed that. Do you? Life and death is real. It's not my intention to scare the hell out of you. Not. I hope you find words of healing and peace and comfort and love through Jesus Christ. See, your relationship with God is the most important relationship you will ever have. If you don't know God, I would invite you to take a walk, go to the lake, go to the ocean, go out in the woods, sit by a creek. sit by a stream, just be silent, be still. God tells each and every one of us, if we will seek him, we will find him. That's his promise. Nancy attended the First Christian Church at Chester. She grew up, got married to the church. I saw some pictures of a young Jack and a young Nancy. She lived her life in that church, where she was loved and cared for. There's good people in that church. They will love you, mentor you, take care of you, help you grow spiritually, because it's a spiritual journey. Myself, I attend a church up on the hills called Everyday Church. It's the old Crow nightclub, and I guess we've been there about 8 years. And our website states, if you attend church, what you will find. It's everyday people, saints, hypocrites, liars, and messed up, each longing for friendship to be accepted and yet challenged to press on your experience and potential in Jesus Christ. I'll tell you, most people that attend up there, they're not so worried about what you've done and where you've been, but they're worried about their spiritual journey and what they're doing to grow in Christ. There's a lot of good churches out there, loved ones. If you don't have a home church, find one. Because one day you'll be facing the same decision, meeting the Lord. Let's have a closing prayer. Father God in heaven, we thank you that we've had this time to share and honor Nancy's life and her love. We ask that you bring blessings upon this family and her friends who are grieving here today. We ask that you turn our grieving into joy, knowing that she's walking with you in heaven, a place where there's no more sorrow or pain or tears, but a place of joy, peace, love, and happiness by your side. Father, we ask if there's anyone here who's not surrendered their life to you, we ask Holy Spirit to fill their hearts and set them free of their sins and guilt, that they too can be free and to walk with you on this earth as is in heaven. Lord, we pray in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine